Hey, what's going on, guys? Today we're popping open the top of another recently released Machine Krieger kit. This is the Lunar Diver Stingray, which is not necessarily a new release. It's been released at least one other time before, if not two other times before, in two other different kit forms, I believe, from Hasegawa. But this one is the Moon Snowman version, so it's got a Moon Snowman patch included. That's going to be the main difference, but we'll see what else is different once we get it open. Let's go ahead and check it out. So hold up, guys, before we actually get to opening up the box and taking a look at the kit, I thought we also might as well in this video take a look at the original Stingray kit so that we can compare them. So this is the original release Lunar Diver Stingray out from Hasegawa as well. When did this one come out? 2009. I also have this in my backlog collection. I've not ever built it yet, obviously, or unboxed it for you guys. So I figured we might as well do just kind of like a double unboxing and we can compare them side by side, see what's different between the two if you decide to go for this one or the other one. There are some key differences definitely to take note of, so let's check out both of these kits. Alright, so let's first take a look here at the original Lunar Diver Stingray, originally released in 2009 from Hasegawa, and this is that style box art where we don't have like the full painting background, but just the painting of contents of the box here, basically, and the Lunar Diver Stingray there in the foreground, plus two power suits, and that is going to be one of the main differences between these kits, aside from the color and markings and everything like that. This one is actually three kits in one, because you have the Lunar Diver Stingray and you have two powered suits included as well. Now these are in 1/35th scale, so they're gonna be in the smaller scale. It's actually the same scale of like the capsule kits that you guys have seen me work with in the past. So you got some cool box art there and some more information for you down here about the contents of the box. You got the Lunar Diver Stingray, one type, four decorations, that means four different decal schemes basically included with this, two different figures, two powered suits, and 1/35th scale, so there you go. On the ends of the box, in typical fashion, we've got one style decal design over here, the snowman, which is what we've got with the new version as like the patch, and then over here, the S skull design right there, which is what you see on the box art. On this side of the box, there's nothing, just the big Machine Krieger logo there and some other different markings over here. On this side, though, we do have some story. So I'll go ahead and put that on the screen for you guys. The Machine Krieger story, 2882 to 2885. You guys can pause the video and read that if you're interested in some of the backstory. And then we have some more backstory here on the back of the box. Some stats information there about the Lunar Diver Stingray, some different views of it from the side and from the top, so you can kind of have a nice big look at kind of the color layout, the design of that, and some more information over here in English. So once again, I'll just kind of go through this slowly. You guys can pause the video and read that if you're so inclined. The whole point of these videos is to just let you guys see what's on the boxes and everything. And if we pop open the box, that's actually not the end of the box art. There is some more printed on the inside of the lower box. This part here is the same information that was on the outside, but we also have it here in Japanese as well. But on the ends of the inner box, we've got some paint schemes here for the ghoul skeleton paint scheme for the fireball prowler. We've got the Japanese version of the information that was on the back of the box, and then on this side, a different color scheme here, the second ground attack company for the fireball prowler there. So lots of artwork to see on the outside of the box. Let's see what we've got inside. It looks like everything's gonna be molded in a pearl white, which is an interesting color that's not ideal, unfortunately. We got some like dark navy blue, it looks like a little bit there for the stand, and a bunch of parts, as like I said, it's basically like three kits, so there's gonna be kind of a lot to build in this one. Here we got the decal sheet, which is quite large. Obviously, this is going to be the main section for the decals for the Luna Diver. And then over here, the decals for the powered suits. So you got those separate and they're very small, but very nicely detailed. Let's take a nice close-up look at these. These look like some decals for like an instrument panel on the inside of the cockpit, which is very cool. And then just your standard caution markings, some of the larger markings there, the printing quality and the color on those does all look quite nice, very cool. We got our standard paint card in here showing a couple of different color variants for that, some information that's all in Japanese. On the back side here is going to be the decal layout. And if we look down below that, this color scheme of it was actually released as another variant. So that's another variant that came out that I don't actually have. So there was this original variant, then this one, which is the Operation Dynamo variant, I believe is what that one was called. And obviously the Moon Snowman version, which we'll be taking a look at after this here today. We have two different manuals here for the Lunar Diver Stingray. Both are actually marked Lunar Diver Stingray, but this of course would be the manual for
the Prowler, the Fireball Prowler kits. So you do have a parts list over here and the construction there for those. I believe they're both, I mean, like, as far as like what you have in here for the parts, you can make them both the same or you can make them both different. So basically there's two different ways to build those, I believe. So it's showing you both different ways to build those. For the Lunar Diver Stingray itself, here we got a little information on the back about how to put on water slides, but obviously you guys probably don't necessarily need that water slide instruction manual there, but there's the parts list and the construction of this guy. So it's a pretty big body for the main section of the Lunar Diver Stingray, so you'll have, I imagine, probably a massive hollow space on the inside, and then there's just a bunch of parts going around on the outside, and some big, long, massive seam lines all around the body. But let's go ahead and check out the runners and find out and see what we got. So we'll take a look at the runners here for the Prowlers first, and the first thing I'm noticing is that the runners are not the same. So maybe you can't actually make two of them the same. You'll make one as the one type and one as the different type, because you'll see there's kind of some different sections here. You only have one of this section and you only have one of this section over here. So those are going to be slightly different. And again, these runners are all in a kind of off-white, kind of space white type color. As far as the details and everything, it's going to be white, so it's going to be hard to show you guys on camera. But not having ever built one of these and only having built the capsule toys, I can see there is going to be some pros and cons. These ones look like there are going to be a little bit more seam heavy, that you're going to have to remove a lot more seams on these. So I don't know, if you have some of the capsule kits, you could very easily just replace it. If you wanted to keep this as a set and instead of using these, you could just use a couple of the 1/35 scale capsule kits instead, and I think you could definitely do that. All right, then getting into the parts for the Luna Diver itself, we do have this runner here, PC9 in gray for a few polycaps. Runners Z and L are in this dark blue color. Runner Z is labeled stand base, which is obviously pretty self-explanatory. That's what that is for the Stingray. And then this is also for the stand base, but the runner is not labeled that way. It's just labeled a 1/35 scale Stingray. So this would be more of the arm that's gonna hold up the kit there for you. And that's got some pretty nice detail on that and a little like earthworm looking part right there. The rest of our runners are all just going to be back in that same off-white, kind of space white color, and it does seem to be slightly pearlescent. Either that or it's just very glossy and it's just catching the light. I don't know if there's actually any pearlescent in there. It does sort of have that appearance. Anyway, this is runner J. We've got two of these, obviously some very tiny little parts on there and some other little bits and bobs. Runners D, E, F, and G are all molded together here on this one large runner made up of a couple of different sections. Runner C contains a couple little tiny parts, but then some of the large parts, like this would be the main halves of the tail and some of the larger parts at the front of the ship. Runner A is going to be obviously our big two main halves of the body and a couple other large parts, a couple little small parts on there. And then runner B is some more of the parts of the body of that, just again all in the same color. This would be the inner part of the cockpit right there. That's where your pilot will sit inside of there, and you can have that closed or open. Here on runner K in this greenish gray color here is going to be our inner cockpit piece with some nice details there, and then our pilot figure. So you can use these if you're going to have the cockpit open, or if you're going to have the cockpit closed, obviously you won't need to use these parts at all, and you can just omit them and just keep them for some other kitbash or something else later on, I suppose. So that is it for the original Luna Diver Stingray. Now you guys have an idea of what we had with that release. And now we can compare that to see what we've got with the new version and see how they differ. So right off the bat, one difference in the boxes, you can see they're not the same size. The original Luna Diver Stingray is a slightly thicker box, and that's because it has the addition of the powered suits, whereas the new Moon Snowman version does not. It's only going to be the Luna Diver Stingray, so it's going to be a little bit cheaper, which is nice, but you don't have the extra suits included, so it's just going to be just the one main kit. We've got horizontal style box art for this one instead of vertical, which is much easier to show on camera, so I appreciate that. Once again, some beautiful artwork of the Luna Diver itself now in this new color scheme. I'm never really quite a fan of the eyes on there. It's cool. I don't know if I'll ever actually paint one like that. But here you can see the contents, one type, four decorations, scale 1/35. That's pretty much it. But then you also have the emblem of Moon Snowman included, which is a fabric needlework patch that you have included. So that's been the thing that they've done for a couple of releases now. This one is the, I think it's just the second one. I think it's just the Bomber Cat version of the Falk, which they released that had a patch. And this is, I believe, the second one that they've released that comes with a special patch included. But anyway, here on the side of the box, we've got the Banana Wings logo right there on this side. On the opposite side, we've got the Moon Snowman patch design there. On this side of the box, we've got some backstory information there, all in Japanese, unfortunately. And on the other side of the box, we've got it here in English. So there that is for you guys. If you want to pause the video and read up on some of the backstory here of the Luna Diver, you can check that out. That does all look very cool. Let's go ahead and open it up. Now I can assume the runners are gonna be basically the same, but right off the bat, you can see a big difference is that these parts are molded in black instead of white, which is very nice to see. So first of all, there's our snowman patch. We'll take a look at that in just a second. The base parts look like those are the same color. The pilot figure and cockpit hatch, inner cockpit piece, that runner, those parts are the same color. So it's just gonna be the main color of plastic for the kit is changed. Let's check out the decals here. Very nice decal options here for this one. You got these small caution markings up there in white, black, and red, a little bit of yellow there, and then our big markings, and you'll have a lot of really cool options. Of course, you got the Moonstone Man and a couple different color options for that. You've got the S skull, you've got the devil guy, you got the snake, you got the eyes, you got the actual stingray, which is fitting. The chest piece, skull and crossbones, some other different eye options, some dice, the winged banana. Very nice options for the decals. We do also, of course, have the paint card. So there's a couple different versions. Here's the flying banana, Master Sergeant Vernon Huslow version of that. Here is the ground type. This is like, I think, the Operation Dynamo version, which I mentioned before, came out as a separate release. And here's the Moon Snowman version here on the other side. So this would be your decal guy, where to place all the decals around on that. And then there's another color scheme for you down there at the bottom. The instruction manual is different in terms of what we've got in here in text form. I'm not sure if there's anything really different about the actual construction of the kit. There might be a couple of small parts that differ from the original, but as far as I know, it should mostly be the same. If there's any, well, we'll take a look at the runners and find out, I guess. All right, so yeah, we've got the polycaps and the parts for the base. Those are exactly the same, even in the same kind of dark blue color, so no change with those. And the K-Runner with our pilot figures and inner cockpit piece here. Again, same color, same parts, so nothing changed with that either. But yeah, big change here for the main color. So this is the A-Runner and it's in black, but it's also kind of like a slightly sparkly black. There's a little bit of sparkle injected in there as far as I can tell. If you take a close-up look, hopefully you guys can see that as well, but that's definitely gonna make this a lot easier for painting, I think. The B-Runner, and so I have to assume that was a very conscious choice to switch the color of this just for, if you're painting these, you know, usually for painting these kits, if you're doing like a Canon color scheme, you wanna start with a dark base. So if you have bright white pearly plastic, then you're gonna have to do a black base on that. Where with these, you really can skip the step of painting a black base on it. You can basically just paint right on top of this black plastic and you're pretty much good to go. So I'm sure that was definitely done on purpose for that reason. Here's runner C with some larger parts on there again for the tail. And then runners D, E, F, and G. Again, this is all the same as with the original kit. So it looks like, as far as the parts go, there's nothing new with this kit. Last thing here would be runner J, which again, we have two of. This one does appear to be in a slightly different color. This is in just like a plain dark gray, sort of like a German gray, almost black kind of color with this, and doesn't have like that sparkle, a little bit of sparkle in the plastic. Looks like just like a straight up dark gray as far as I can tell. And of course, the main attraction is the snowman patch, which looks very nice. Let me get this open here. The size of this guy is gonna be right about just shy of 10 centimeters in height, or if you're in the US, that'd be just under 4 inches. And yeah, very cool. I don't know yet where I'm gonna put this. I'll have to get a jacket or a backpack or something I can put this on, but I'm definitely looking forward to putting this on somewhere where I can wear this around. That's awesome. So there you have it, guys. The same kit, two different flavors. Which one is right for you? Well, that's for you to decide. There's some definite pros and cons either way. This one, you get the two extra powered suits in there, which is really nice. This one, you get the patch. And honestly, in my personal preference, I prefer the decals with the new version, but depending on what you want, they both look like really fun kits. This has been a design that I've really liked for a long time. I've just unfortunately not had a chance to actually build one of these yet, so definitely looking forward to building one of these up, both of them eventually, but I'll probably go ahead and build up the Moon Snowman version first, you know, once I'm all set up in the new space. So sometime next year, you guys will see me working on this guy. And I'm looking forward to sharing that experience with all of you. But for now, I hope this video was interesting and helpful for you guys. If you're interested in these kits, of course, you can check them out at USA Gundam Store. The link and the coupon code will be for you guys down in the video description down there. So check that out. check some of these kits out if you never have, or if you're a fan of them and you just didn't know that we have them at US Second-Home Store, now you know, and you can check them out there on the site. The new Moon Snowman version of the Stingray looks awesome, so I'm definitely looking forward to working on that in the future. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and until next time, hope you're all having a great day. Thank you so much for your support. I'll see y'all next time. Bye, guys.